This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome to episode 40. In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve an inequality that contains an absolute value sign. In a previous episode, we've already seen how to solve an absolute value equation, but I'm going to show you what to do if you see a greater than or a less than sign. Let's have a look at it. All right, our inequality says absolute value of 3x plus 5 plus 1 greater than 8. The first thing you want to do is get the absolute value sign by itself. This means we have to subtract negative 1 from both sides, so our absolute value still has 3x plus 5. Now it's greater than 8 minus 1, which is 7. Again, just like the absolute value equations, our next step will be to split this inequality into two. And once again, just like the equations, we'll have 3x plus 5 greater than 7 as our positive version. And then we'll have a negative version where we change the sign of the number on the right and change the inequality sign as well. So our second inequality will be 3x plus 5 less than, because we're going to change the sign here, negative 7, because we're also going to change the sign on the number. This will be our negative version. Let's look at the positive one first. Let's try to get x by itself. So we'll subtract 5 from both sides. This gives us 3x on the left greater than 7 minus 5 is 2. Then we'll simply divide both sides by 3, so we'll have x greater than 2/3 as our first answer. Now we'll have a look at the negative version. Once again, we want to try to get x by itself here, so we first subtract the 5 from both sides. This will give us 3x less than negative 7 minus 5 is negative 12. Then we'll divide both sides by 3. This gives us x less than negative 4. That's our other solution. Now let's draw the picture on this little arrow down below. We'll place our infinities first, negative infinity and positive infinity. Let's also mark down where 0 is, along with the 2/3, which should be slightly to the right of it, and then negative 4, which should be somewhere off to the left. Because this is greater than without the equal to sign, this will be open, and for the same reason, the other inequality will also be open. We'll draw the open circles for both numbers. Now, the inequality that says 2/3 says greater than, so our answer will be only the numbers greater than 2/3. Our second inequality says less than negative 4, so we will also have the numbers less than negative 4, which means we have two regions in our answer. The region in the middle will not be part of the answer, but the areas that I have marked in red will be. So the first part of our answer will be negative infinity to negative 4. From region A. Union region B, which is 2/3 to infinity. So that we have two regions in our answer. And just as a warning, greater than will generally give us two regions in our answer. Now, what if we had less than instead? We'll have a look at that example as well. So I'm going to use the same equation, except for the sign is no longer greater than, it's less than. Let's repeat the process that we did earlier. Get the absolute value sign by itself. We already know that that will be less than 7. We'll split it into two inequalities. We already know the first inequality is 3x plus 5 less than 7. The other one will change the sign of the inequality and change the sign of the number on the right, so that we'll have 3x plus 5 greater than negative 7. We've already done the algebra before, but I'll go through it quickly again. We'll subtract 5 from both sides. It'll work the same for both equations. For the first equation, we'll have 3x less than 7 minus 5 is 2. And then we'll divide both sides by 3. Again, we'll get 2/3, but this time it says x is less than 2/3. For the right-hand equation, we'll have 3x greater than negative 7 minus 5 gives, again, negative 12. We'll divide both sides by 3 so that x is greater than negative 4. We've already seen these answers, so I'm going to place them on the number line once again. Negative infinity, positive infinity. We'll mark down where 0 is, and again place the 2/3 slightly to the right, the negative 4 somewhere to the left, and place the open circles on negative 4 and 2/3. But the way this answer is going to look is going to be significantly different from the last one, even though the numbers are the same, because we have different inequality signs. Here we have x is less than 2/3. So I'll draw a line pointing to the left to show that it's less. And we have x greater than negative 4, so I'm going to draw a line to the right to show that it's greater. Do you see the region where they overlap between the negative 4 and the 2/3, right here in the middle? That zone in the middle is going to be our solution. So instead of having two regions, we only have one region in our answer. The reason we have only one region is that's generally what's going to happen if you have less than in your inequality originally. We're going to say that region is negative 4, comma, 2/3, surrounded by parentheses because both points are open. And that's how you solve an absolute value inequality. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next episode.